black history has been saturated with terror and horror. The event of the 1921 Tulsa Race Massacre, also known as the Black Wall Street Massacre, consisted of a mob of whites attacking black-owned businesses and residency. The attack was carried out on the ground and from private aircraft, destroying more than 35 square blocks of the wealthiest black community at that current time. More than 300 dead and over 6,000 imprisoned, with the event stemming from a black shoe shiner accused of assaulting a 17-year-old white female. This is one of the many horrific events infused in the history of the Black American. Black people have been enslaved, tortured, discriminated, and eventually killed simply due to the pigment of their skin. The horror genre translated these stereotypes of the Black American being lazy, buffoonish, superstitious, and there were numerous slurs created to deplete and belittle their existence. There was a film during the 1930s that was claimed to be a documentary known as Ngagi, which showed African women being offered as sex slaves to gorillas, but in actuality it was filmed in Los Angeles with white actresses in blackface in place of black women. The rest of the 20th century slowly closed the gap in the divide and racism towards black Americans in the horror genre, which led to black people being casted more on the big screen. However, they were usually the first person to get killed off in the film or either showed resemblance of the monster. The 1970s were known as the Black Exploitation Era, where African Americans were more noticeable in more films, but it helped fuel several stereotypes by deeming the black man as a pimp and the black woman as a hoe. Nevertheless, there was fewer black cliche deaths in horror films and allowed more films to feature an African American as the leading role.
No, I don't want to get chased off the lawn with a shotgun.
You're not going to. First of all, my dad would have voted for Obama a third time if he could have. Like, the love is so real.
Many directors, writers, and actors have previously knocked down barriers and paved the way for a new generation of black talent to tackle present social issues through the horror genre, and I believe that Jordan Peele was at the forefront. Jordan Peele debuted with a blockbuster hit that was filled with symbolism and satire relating to black issues. There were symbols of slavery in the Old South, especially with the plantation at stake. Throughout the film, the protagonist becomes victimized through a hypnotism that's performed with a teacup. The stirring of the tea is a symbol of courtesy, but is used as a weapon of destruction. The history associated with tea is very dark and sinister, considering events like the Boston Tea Party and colonialism through the trade of tea.
And then sit with me, please. Just for a little while.
The hypnosis ultimately pushes down the protagonist, restrains his will, and he's sent into the sunken place.
So you won't be gone, not completely. A sliver of you will still be in there somewhere, limited consciousness. You'll live in
the sunken place.
Throughout the plot, the sunken place is exhibited as the state of unconsciousness, but the audience is able to draw the symbolism relating to the disenfranchised African American being denied a quality level of education, thus pushing them further down the rabbit hole. The ultimate villain in this film is Chris Washington's wife, Rose, who seems to have a liberal view on life due to the fact that she's living in the city and away from the suburbs, which the audience would also attribute to her stepping away from her family's history, and she shows signs of this by acting like an enlightened liberal when the cop decides to interrogate Chris.
I didn't ask who was driving. I asked to see his ID.
Yeah, why? That's
Doesn't make any sense.
Here.
No. Fuck that. You don't have to give him your ID because you haven't done anything wrong.
Rose's duplicity in the film is evident towards the conclusion of the plot when it is revealed that she is still very loyal and committed to her family's history by luring black men onto the family's property. After Chris kills Rose's family, she is still keen on capturing him and chases him. But unfortunately, Chris manages to overpower her, but in the end, she still tries to use her privilege to try and exploit him. Once the audience notices the police lights, people start to feel the inevitable. They all knew what would occur if it was a white police officer that was stepping out of the vehicle. In the original screenplay, Jordan Peele intended a desolate ending, but with the numerous cases of police brutality, he felt that the audience wanted an escape from reality, a hero. It's safe to say that the future of black horror is in great hands, and the 21st century will be dominated with black writers, black protagonists, and black directors in the horror genre, just like how black people dominate pop culture. Thank you, and have a good one.